Good to be in God's house. Amen. Glad that God woke us up this morning. Amen. Allowed us to live another day to see Him. Amen. To worship Him this morning. Amen. Well, Brother Eller, I can't see Him. Why can't you? Amen. If you look at your brother and sister, you see Him. Amen. If they're living right, you see Him. But it's good to be in God's house this morning. We got a lot to pray about. I actually remember Brother Bob Sandlin and his family. His wife's daddy passed away, and Brother Bob's really having it real hard. He was going to give his church up, but then he decided that the Holy Ghost told him no, it wasn't time, amen, for him to give his church up. But he's had a lot of deaths in the family lately, and this has really took a toll on him. But remember, Brother Bob, amen, he's a good preacher, a good man of God, and I'm going to try to get him down here one weekend, let him preach for us. But he is a real good man of God. I mean, I listen to him. I watch him. I watch his service. He's got a little grandson that can preach. Well, he's 8 years old, and he can flat out just lay on the line. Amen. But remember that family this morning. Also remember the young man that Noah's been requesting for, Tim McClellan, the preacher at had a stroke, and they had to cut part of his brain up, had to cut part of his head open to relieve the pressure off of his brain. And then Nora's brother Rusty called last night and asked us to be praying for his friend Charles Spears, who's had a stroke, a bad stroke, and asked him to pray for him. Amen. There's a lot of people having strokes, and but I actually remember him. He needs to know the Lord. Remember Rusty also, he's really been battling with his nerves, has been really bothering him. Amen. So remember him in your prayers this morning. Also remember Brother Timmy Brown, Sister Tammy. Amen, Sister Tammy. Amen. She's got blood gathered up around her. Amen. And she has to go every once in a while and have it drained off. So remember her this morning. Remember Chris. He got to come home. He's recovering. Amen. He still needs prayer. Amen. So remember him this morning. Anybody else got a prayer request this morning? Yes. Amen. Also remember Sister Ann Johnson today. Amen. She's not doing good neither. Amen. So remember her. Somebody else. Somebody else. Yes, remember, I talked to a gentleman, Friday. He's the owner of WLOC over in Horse Cave, the radio station. And we used to go around when we were singing. We used to sing benefits with this group. It's the Sexton. And but his granddaughter, she's 17 years old, or niece, his niece. She's 17 years old. She had nodules on her throat. And they went in there to check and see what was going on, and they went there to take them out to do biopsy on them. And the doctor slipped and cut her vocal cords in two. And he was really upset, crying about it, the doctor was, and everything. But they went and put it all back, sewed it all back together and everything. And so they hoped that it would take and not come apart. But he said, pray for her. He said, because the other day she told him bye. And last Sunday, she wanted to try to sing at the church, and all she could do was barely whisper. But he said, pray that God would give her her voice back where she can sing, because she's just 17 years old. He said, I know God. I said, yes, we'll put her in our prayer box. So her name is Nicole. Nicole, and I think her mother's name is Heather. Amen. So remember them this morning. Amen. She's 17 years old, and it's bad because he said they think one of the nodules came back, the C word. And he said, we ain't going to class. No, we won't find that neither. Amen. So remember that this morning. Amen. Also, he said, pray for his radio station. So remember his radio station over there, and that God will continue blessing it. Anybody else this morning? Yes, amen. Remember that. Somebody else? Remember Brother Danny Patrick, he's supposed to go have back surgery again, so ask you to remember him. Also remember the service today. Amen. Remember each and every one. Pray for each and every one. Amen. Listen, there's a lot of lost souls, amen, that needs to be saved. I know in your family, Nora's baby brother, amen, he's been watching our church services, and he's been reposting them, and so, you know, that's a start. Amen. I like seeing him in the house of God. He's a drummer. He played drums real good. But remember him and his family. Remember his mother-in-law. She's got the old C word. Amen. She's been battling it for a while. As you remember that. Also remember Kim Keaton this morning. Amen. In your prayers. Amen. She lost her husband about 2 weeks ago. As you remember her in your prayers. Told me still when she got ready to get baptized, she was going to call me. Amen. So just remember her. Amen. She gets things fixed up with the Lord. Nora and Jackie's niece, Nora's cousin, and Connie's. Amen. Cookie Simmons. Remember her and her family. Amen. That God will get a hold of them and save their soul. Nora's cousin, Paul Runyon. Talked to him again last night. He's got to go Thursday and have some shots in his eyes where they said that he's got blood under both his eyes real bad. It's what's making him not be able to see. So remember him, but most of all that he finds salvation. Amen. Anybody else before we pray? Water service next Sunday. As far as I know, the water's not up down there, so that's good. Amen. I'm going to have to go and find out, make sure, amen, that everything's good to go. We'll have, you know, we got more rain coming in, but they thought we wasn't going to get that much, but we just want to make sure. I don't want to play it by ear, but we'll be having our water service and be having our dinner on the ground. Amen. Potluck. Rainwater, don't bring a pot, says luck on it. Just fix a pot. Fix stuff, bring it. Amen. Boil some cabbage, fry some taters, or whatever. Amen. Barbecue chicken. Hey, that's what it's about. We want to see somebody get saved. Amen. We want to see somebody get touched and healed and delivered. Amen. Set free from this old sinful world. But remember that, amen, it's coming up. It's just right here on us. And we're hoping and praying that everything goes good. We'll be able to have this water service. And I'm excited about it, amen. And I hope everybody else is too. You say, well, brother, why are we supposed to? Hey, we're going to have church. Just like we're having church here, we're going to have church. Amen. We're going to have our music down there. We're just going to have church. It starts at 12. It gives you plenty of time to get up and get your stuff ready. And we're gonna fix some plugs. We're gonna have some place to plug stuff up down there. I got the wire at the house. All the other things gotta do, we just gotta go get a box to put on it. And we'll be good to go. God's gonna take care of it. it. Amen. I believe we're going to see somebody get touched, somebody get saved. Wouldn't that be awesome? Just go to one soul. If just one soul gets saved, it's worth it all. Because that one soul can go and tell somebody else. Amen. Remember that. Somebody else today before we pray. Yes, remember Brother Darrell and Sister Frances and little Artie out in California, Sister Carly Pope and her family, Sister Martha Burkett and her family, Sister Judy McCarty and her family, Sister Lynn and her family. Amen. Sister Lynn lives in Missouri. Amen. She's moved to Missouri, but she still watches us. So remember her and her family. Amen. Out there. We got several people out in Arkansas, Arizona, Oklahoma. We got some new ones in Oklahoma that's been watching. We got people in Pennsylvania. We got people in Maryland. We got people in West Virginia, North Carolina, South Carolina, Florida. If I go off, name all of them. We got them all over the United States watching. We even got them out of the United States watching us. Amen. And they tell us they really appreciate us praying for them. Amen. And that's what it's about. Amen. It's people praying. We got churches over in Kenya that's watching us. We got people over in Kenya. We got people over in India. We got people over in Pakistan, Iowa. We got them all over. Amen. And I give God the praise for that. Amen. And I thank the Lord for that. Remember all those that's on TikTok and Big Old Live and Facebook Live this morning? Amen. Brother Josh, is there any idea on Facebook this morning in prayer request? Amen. Also remember Brother Ray Crenshaw, Sister Linda, and their grandson Peyton. Amen. In your prayers. Remember Kevin Payne. I saw him the other day. Remember him and his wife Sandy. Amen. In your prayers, also, Brother Kevin, amen, needs a touch from the Lord. So I ask y'all to remember them in prayer this morning. Unspoken quest by the Sister Charlotte. Oh, unspoken quest by the raising of your hand. Pray at your seat or pray at the altar.
Thank you.
your soul. And ask Brother Michael to come up, amen, this morning, take up our morning's tithes and offering. Amen. Give what God lays on your heart. God bless you. Those that's going to help Sister Noel, amen, make your way on up, amen.
Thank you. Praise the
Lord. This is the Lord's house.
Amen. Everybody is welcome in God's house. Amen. Hallelujah. I was listening to somebody the other day, and they said, well, we're not welcome in this place. I said, well, listen. Amen. You hear things. Amen. And you see things. Amen. There's a lot of churches won't let people come into their house. Amen. If you don't dress like them, you don't drive the same kind of car like they drive, you don't smell like them. Amen. And you don't look like them. Amen. They don't want you in their house. Amen. But let me tell you something. Amen. This is God's house. Amen. It's not our house. He just lets us borrow this. Amen. And he said, whosoever will, let them come. He didn't say that they had to be rich. Amen. He went around to the poor. You read the Bible. Amen. He went around the poor people. He went around the sinners. Amen. And he taught the word of God to them. Amen. He didn't care what they looked like, what they smell like, what they dressed like. Amen. He was just looking at what they needed. Amen. And that's what we're supposed to do. We're not supposed to turn nobody away from the house of God. Amen. Nobody. Amen. They're supposed to be able to come into God's house. Amen. This is a place of refuge. Amen. This is a place of help. Amen. It's not just a place to come and gather. Amen. Socialize. Amen. It's a house of God. It's a place to come to worship.
Amen.
It's a place to come to give God honor and praise. Amen. It is good. Amen. To know. Amen. That we got a place we can come and worship the Lord. Amen. There's people. I was listening to people up in Canada. They don't want them to come in the house of God and worship. They don't want them to go into their house of Lord and worship. They're wanting to try to shut their houses down. Amen. But God, amen, took care of that problem. Amen. But I came today to see God do something for somebody. Amen. And it is good, amen, to know that God is real. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm going to ask Sister Bonnie to come and sing Chainbreaker for me. She ain't sung that twice. Amen. I want to hear her sing Chainbreaker this morning. Amen. That song was Carrie's song because she used to, when she would go through her problems that she was going through, God was helping her with that. Amen. That there is a God that can break chains and holds you and binds you. Amen.
Been hearing the same old voice, tell the same old lies. If you try to feel the same old holes inside, there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way. We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight.
Yeah, hallelujah.
We've all run to things we know just ain't right. There's a better life. There's a better life.
My heart was still the same. Yeah.
Fire burning inside with Thank you.
Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
He was the last one to leave. Walked to his car in the dark, got out his keys. His old ragged Bible he placed on the seat by his side. Lord, I close my bed. Now you do the rest. And
God has been so good. Thank you.
going to read something the Lord just laid on my heart.
Amen. I have something for you this morning that the Lord said right there. Amen. I just want to read something. It's in Psalms chapter 45. Amen. The presence of the Lord has been in this place.
Amen.
Amen. If you ain't felt the presence of the Lord, then your wood's wet. That's all I got to tell you.
Amen.
Amen. But the Bible says in Psalms chapter 45, amen, it said, my heart is intent, a good matter. I speak of things which I have made, things which I have made. Touching the king, my tongue is the pen of a ready writer. Hallelujah. David's talking here. Listen to that. Thou art fairer than the children of men. Grace is poured into thy lips. Therefore, God has blessed thee forever. Girt thy sword upon thy thigh, O most mighty, with thy glory and thy majesty. And in the majesty ride
prosperously
because of the truth and meekness and righteousness. And thy right hand shall teach thee terrible things. Thine arrows are sharp in the heart of the king's enemies, whereby the people fall under thee. Thou throne, O God, is forever and ever. The scepters of the kingdom is the right scepter. Thou lovest righteousness and hateth wickedness. Therefore God thy God has anointed thee with the oil of gladness above thy fellow. All the garments shall smell, all the garments smell of myrrh and alloy and cassia out of the ivory place, palaces, whereby thou have made thee glad. King's daughters were among the honorable women. Upon thy right hand did stand the queen in gold of Ophrah. Hearken, O daughter, and consider, and incline thine ear. Forget also thine own people and thy father's house. So shall the king gather greatly, desire thy beauty, for he is thy Lord, and worship thou him. And the daughter of Tyre shall be there with a gift. Even the rich among the people shall entreat thy favor. The king's daughter is all glorious. Within her clothing is of wrought gold. She shall be brought unto the king in raiment of needleworking. The virgin, her companions that follow her, shall be brought unto thee with gladness and rejoicing. Shall they be brought? They shall enter into the king's palace, in the king's palace. Entreat of thy father, instead of thy father, shall be thy children, whom thou mayest make princes in all the earth. I will make thy name to be remembered in all generations. Therefore shall the people praise thee forever and ever. Listen to verse number 6. In verse number 7. Thy throne, O God, is forever and ever. The scepter of thy kingdom is the right scepter. Thou lovest the righteous and hatest the wicked. Therefore, God, thy God has anointed thee with the oil of gladness above thy fellow. God spoke to me as the Spirit of God began to start falling in the church. Amen. That God Himself, amen, loves our praises. And when the daughters begin to praise Him, amen, and they begin to shine forth as a queen, amen, unto God, God inhabits that praise. And well, Brother Miller, what about, hey, tell me how many women's in here and how many men's in here? We're outnumbered, men. You say, what are you talking about, Brother Miller? God inhabits the praises of His children. Amen. Don't matter if it's men or women, but He likes it when the daughters, amen, begin to worship and begin to praise. See, I was just sitting with my eyes closed and I was just thinking about what God's doing. Sister Jackie, amen, was you going to preach this morning? No, I just wanted to read what God wanted me to read to you this morning. Amen, I just have to preach to you what God gave me this morning for tonight. You don't want to miss it, I'll just tell you that. Amen. But listen, when God loves His children, and He don't like to see them hurt. He don't like to see His children hurt. And He wants to show His love towards us. And sometimes it hurts Him that He has to scold us. But He has to. Sometimes it hurts moms and dads to scold their children, but they have to. I remember my mom, amen, she hated that to scold us and whoop us, but she said, it hurts me more than it does you. Amen, but I'm like Aaron Wilbur. Get on the other side of the stick, and we'll see which one hurts the worst. Amen. So it's like that with God, amen. When God whoops you, it hurts a whole lot worse than what mom and daddy whoops you, amen. But God loves the children. He loves us enough, amen. And this morning He come in to show you how much He loves you. Amen. He showed His love towards us today. Amen. He showed us His love. Well, remember, y'all ain't got no preaching today. We didn't have to. God showed up.
That's right, man.
Amen. When God shows up, we just sat back. But He spoke this scripture to my mind. Just standing here, He said, Psalms 45. Sister Kathy, I looked down at that, verse number 7. Thou lovest the righteous. The righteousness. And hateth the wickedness. Therefore God, thy God, has anointed thee with the oil of gladness above thy fellow. Ain't you glad that God can anoint you with that oil? Amen. And gladness. Amen. The Bible even speaks of the smelling of the scents and the garment that smelled of myrrh. Myrrh has got a special scent to it. It's got a special smell to it. And cinnamon has got a special smell to cinnamon. A pomegranate has got a special smell. If you read the Bible, the pomegranate was mentioned all through the Bible. A pomegranate's got a special smell. But it has a lot of seeds in it. Thousands of seeds. You know what we're supposed to be? We're supposed to be the seed of Christ. We're supposed to sow that seed. Amen. Sow the seed of Christ. And as I was listening to the Lord and I was watching people, the Spirit of God just moving. Through the songs, through the praise, Sometimes we come in here and we're hurting. That's what the church is for. It's a hospital for the hurting. Sister Tracy, it's a hospital for those that's sick, that need a touch from the Lord. Amen. A lot of people get it all mixed up. Amen. But that's what the church used to. They used to come to the church to be healed. Amen. They didn't run to the doctors. They didn't run to the hospitals. They come to the Lord. Amen. First. They came to God first. Amen. And God said, by your faith. It's got to be your faith. Amen. We can have the faith, but if you ain't got the faith, then it ain't going to do no good. Amen. That's what he told that man when they laid him down. His friends laid him down through the roof. They tore the roof off. And they laid him down through the roof. And I read up on that in history on that. That was an old slate roof that was on top of that building. And they took their fist in their hands and they broke through that roof to put their friend down that roof so he could be touched by Jesus. And Jesus told him, said, it wasn't your faith. And that man got, it wasn't your faith, but it was your friend's faith. By their faith, you were made whole. Amen. So sometimes people in the church needs their friend to tear the roof off for them. Amen. And get through to the Lord for them. Amen. And let God touch somebody. Amen. Sometimes I need somebody to break through the roof for me sometimes. Amen. Because I need prayer sometimes myself. You in here need prayer for yourself. Amen. You need friends, amen, to tear off the roof. Amen. When they tore off that roof, the Bible, their hands was bloody. That showed how good a friend they was. Amen. To being able to tear that roof off so they could lower him down. They didn't have hammers. They used their fists to break through it. That's how much they wanted him to be healed. Amen. And that's how much we want people in the church to be healed. Amen. We want to tear the roof off. Amen. That God would touch somebody and heal them. Look, Sister Jackie sitting here. Amen. She's been putting corn up and after just get out of the hospital, she's been cooking meals and she's been putting corn up. You can't tie her down. I don't care how much you try, you can't tie her down. The Lord said, I'm trying to slow her down. She said, but Lord, they gave me young blood. Now I got young blood. Amen. But we prayed a lot for Sister Jackie. Amen. We tore the roof down for her. Amen. Prayed a lot. Prayed for Sister Teresa. Amen. And God healed her of neuropathy. Amen. Healed Sister Charlotte. Amen. She don't smoke no more. Amen. He took that all away from her. Amen. Touched her. Yes. Amen. Next month will be a year. Amen. But you see, God is, he loves his daughters. There's a lot of men won't talk about the women because they don't want. But listen, God loved the women in the Bible. If you read the Bible, he loved those women in the Bible. He used them. Amen. Deborah. Naomi. Ruth. Esther. Amen. Mary. Mary Magdalene.
Miriam.
Amen. The woman at the well. Amen. He used Rahab the harlot. Amen. God liked the women. Why do you think he said that wisdom is a she? Amen. He even said that hell is enlarging her mouth daily. Her mouth daily. You say, Brother Miller, I don't understand that, but God loves his daughters. Amen. He loves the men. Amen. We got to keep our arrows sharpened. Amen. So we can attack the enemy when the enemy comes in and tries to destroy. Amen. That our arrow and our sword is ready. The sword is the word of God. Amen. Anybody want to give God some praise this morning for what he's done already? Amen. Like I told you, I'm not going to preach. I just want to read what God laid on my heart here. Amen. I had a message. Amen. I done got it all. Scriptures wrote down for it. But God said, not right now. Amen, because he done been in the place. Anybody want to give God some praise?
I want to thank God for healing my children and me this week. I want to thank you for what he's done today. And I want to thank you for what he's going to do.
Amen.
Somebody else. Hey, this is y'all's time. Amen. Give God some praise. He likes his daughters to give him praise and worship. Amen. Man, somebody else. Right.
It's not a first show. It's not the big stage.
Right.
I ask him all the time to let people feel his presence, to see him, to feel his presence. If it meant for me to hide behind a wall, I'd be fine with that. But I thank him for every time he has never, ever failed.
That's right. Yes, hallelujah.
Even though we go through things and we don't understand, God is still always right there.
Yes.
And I appreciate him. I love this church. I love everybody. They're like family to me. And I just desire y'all's prayers.
Yes, amen. Hallelujah. Somebody else. Somebody else. Amen. Anybody else want to give God some praise? Praise the Lord. Somebody else. His time. Amen. Somebody else.
I want to thank the Lord for Tuesday and Morris.
Yes. Tuesday, Brother Morris will be 75 years old. Amen. Come to. Amen. Still mowing the yard. Still cutting bushes and trimming bushes up. He's still going. He's like an energized bunny. He gets that energy and he goes. Then he gets wore out. Amen. All right, I'm going to ask the whole church, if they will, I want them to pray for me. I can't lift my right arm. I can't move my right arm. It's hurting so bad I can't hardly move it. I want y'all to pray for me that God will touch my right arm. Amen. If you noticed, I couldn't even raise up and pray for Sister Darlene with my right arm. But I know God can touch it. Amen. And I want the whole church, amen, if they will, to come and pray for me that God will just touch my arm. Sometimes God just comes in on the scene, amen, and we just step back and let him do what he's got to do. Amen. We don't override the Spirit of God. Amen. But we want to tell you, we appreciate you, TikTok. We love you. Big Old Live, we appreciate y'all. We love you. Facebook Live, we appreciate y'all. We love you. Please, please, tune us back in tonight at 6 o'clock. Amen. Look, 6, just a little after. Amen. I'll get everything set up and ready to go. Amen. But please, tune us back in tonight. Amen. God's gave me a message. Amen. If he don't intervene tonight, if he intervenes tonight, we'll just step back and let him have his way again tonight. But listen, amen, there's a message that God wants to go out. Amen. And I believe it's for somebody that needs it. Amen. So please, if you can, don't miss tonight. Amen. Because it might be just for you tonight. Amen. It might be just for you. Amen. But we appreciate y'all. We love you, live stream. We appreciate y'all. Amen. May God bless you from He's Alive Community Church. Is our prayers until 6 o'clock tonight. May God bless you. Amen. That goes pretty good.